This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. We simplify the following expressions using the basic trig identities. We've now covered the basic identities, which are these reciprocal identities, tangent and cotangent in terms of sine and cosine, the three Pythagorean identities, and the even and odd identities. And we're going to use these basic trig identities to simplify some expressions. All right, so here's our first one. All right, so we have sine to the fourth x minus sine squared x over the secant of x. All right, so some of the things you're going to have to think about doing are factoring. Those are some possibilities. Changing things so they're all in terms of sines and cosines, etc. So the first thing I see here is when I have a sine to the fourth x minus sine squared x, I see I have a common factor, okay? I also see I have a difference of two squares. So there's different ways you might, you know, approach this problem. I see I have a secant, which I could write in terms of cosine. So there's a lot of ways to get started, and there isn't only one correct way to do it. So I'll be doing, you know, it the way that it occurs to me. So the first thing I'm going to do is factor out a sine squared x out of the numerator. Sine squared x, and that gives me sine squared x minus 1. And in the denominator, I'm going to go ahead and write that secant of x as 1 over cosine. So that's 1 over cosine of x. Don't forget to write the x. All right, now, hopefully you recognize this sine squared x minus 1 looks not quite like cosine squared x, because that would be 1 minus sine squared x, but it's just the opposite, right? So sine squared x minus 1 could be written as negative cosine squared x, which you may or may not realize. Another thing is I see I've got this dividing by 1 over cosine x. That means I could multiply by the reciprocal, multiply by cosine x in the numerator. So there's a couple things I'm going to do here for my next step. I'm going to leave this sine squared x as is. Okay. And you can either write negative cosine squared x, or what I'm going to do is show you how you can get it a different way. Sine squared x is the same thing as 1 minus cosine squared x minus 1. Now here's why I decided to see if I get it in terms of the cosine of x. I saw I had a cosine down here, so this may or may not pan out for me. So I have a cosine x in the numerator. Hopefully you understand that's because if you're dividing by 1 over cosine x, you're multiplying by a cosine x. All right, so that's what I've got so far. Now I've got sine squared x times what? Well, these 1s, minus 1 is going to be going, and so I have sine squared x times, what does this give me? Just a plain old negative cosine squared x? Times this cosine of x. So finally, what I have this minus sign, right? I've got sine squared x, and how many cosine x's do I have? I have cosine cubed x. And that's as far as I could go. Now, if you wouldn't have changed this sine squared x minus 1 to a negative cosine squared x, your problem would look a little bit different. And it's hard to really say what the most simplified form is. But if you don't have the minus sign, it seems like this is a little bit more simplified. All right, here's our next problem. Cosine cubed x plus sine squared x cosine of x all over secant x. Again, I see I have a common factor in this numerator, so I'm going to begin by factoring. Another thing you can do is, if you see a secant of x, you could write it as 1 over a cosine x, or you could go ahead and just move it right up to the numerator as a cosine of x. All right, so in the numerator here, I'm going to factor out a cosine x from this original numerator, and that gives me cosine squared x plus sine squared x. And then I am going to write this secant squared that was in the denominator as a cosine of x. All right, you don't have to show that step where you put 1 over cosine and then divide by 1 over cosine and then write that as times cosine. That's okay to do that directly. And now, hopefully you see an identity staring at you in the face right here. Right here, that's one of our basic identities, the fundamental identity, the Pythagorean identity, cosine squared x plus sine squared x equals 1. So we really just have cosine of x times 1 times cosine of x, which is just cosine squared x. So there we are. Again, you might approach this slightly differently, but that's, I think, about as simplified as we can get. All right, here's the next one. Oh, now I got to deal in the numerator with this problem using the basic identities for odd functions, because the sine is an odd function and I have a negative x in there. So I'm going to do that first. Remember, this means the sine of negative x times the sine of negative x times the sine of negative x. In the denominator, well, I'm going to factor out a sine of x, because I see I've got at least the same angle here. So if I factor out a sine of x, that'll give me 1 minus sine squared x. And I hope you recognize that you're looking at an identity right there, 1 minus sine squared x. All right, so what's going on in the numerator? Well, the sine of negative x, that's a negative sine of x because it is odd, right? Times another negative sine of x times another negative sine of x. In the denominator, I have one sine of x. And what identity is this? 1 minus sine squared x. That's one you should be very comfortable with. That's the same thing as the cosine of x. So that is the, I'm sorry, cosine squared of x, right? That comes from the basic identity, cosine squared x plus sine squared x equals 1. If you solve for cosine squared x, you get 1 minus sine squared x. All right, so what do we have in the numerator? We have a negative times a negative times a negative. So it's going to be negative. And let's see, everything's factored. So you know what? I can cancel this sine x with one of those sine of x's, just like I can cancel this negative with that negative. So what I have left in the numerator is just a negative, right, that we already decided, and sine x times sine x, which is sine squared x. And in the denominator, we have cosine squared x. All right, here's an identity hopefully you're seeing. Do you see how you've got a sine over a cosine? They're both squared. So those are the same as sine x over cosine x squared. And what's the sine x over cosine x? That is tangent. So I've got negative tangent x squared, or negative tangent squared x is the way we would finish that one. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.